So Fortnite is very hard at shooting compared to a lot of games out there. So we get how difficult aiming can be for those with less shooter experience. Being able to land shots at long distances or track an opponent in a build fight can have huge implications on the outcome of your game. When it comes down to it, I mean, even missing a single flick shot can just cost you the win. Who's ever been there? I know I have. So no matter how much you build, you're going to eventually have to land your shots. And with the new no-build zones introduced, good aim has become more important than ever. What's up, everybody? This is your guy, your friend, Keith Allen. And make sure to connect with me on my Instagram. Hey, we got a lot going on. I like to post up videos to just encourage you guys and inspire you to be the best that you can be at Fortnite. So, in this video, we're going to be sharing a few ways to help you improve your aim. We're going to start off by talking about aim training in creative and the different aiming styles you can work on. And so after that, we're also going to be discussing a game mode we don't really see played nearly enough, but it is still one of the best ways to grind out and improve your aim. So before we get started, ProGuys has a small announcement to make. We're going to be adding a ton of new features to our site, exclusive guide videos for our pro members, also Pro Pass now grants access to all games. We also have more free coaching passes and points for InstaPro if you're a pro member. So head on over to ProGuys by clicking the link in the description below. So usually playing aim training maps before you hop into the actual modes, you know, it's probably one of the most consistent ways you can help improve your aim. Pretty much every pro player does it, and it's a staple in essentially every shooter's game warm-up routine. We know we talk a lot about it in our videos, and that's just because of how important it is. Not only are you going to be a better shot than if you didn't warm up that day, but your skills are going to steadily progress over time. Now, I'm not going to mention Kovacs since it only applies to PC players, and okay, let's be real here, regardless of how good Kovacs really is, it can't match creative maps and close quarters turtle wars. Why? Well, it's simple. Training your aim with actual in-game mechanics and character models beats anything else, right? That's why we're going to show you the best maps for that today. Okay, so if you're looking for an aim training map to play, check out Don Wozy's aiming course. It consists of a tile frenzy section as well as two areas for practicing your flicking and tracking. There's also a fourth section with a few practice courses that mix building with aiming, which is really cool. What's great about this map is that even with so many courses, you don't experience as many frame drops as a lot of other training courses. So it should be pretty much more console friendly. One style of aiming you need to practice, guys, is flicking. Okay, so flicks are when you quickly move your crosshair towards your target, right? Using instincts to land the shots. Flicking isn't necessary or anything like that, but hey, sometimes you need to be able to land a shot quickly, especially in shotgun fights. And the only way to really get better at flicks is just to practice them. Okay, so when training your flicks, you're not trying to hit every single target with 100% accuracy, guys. Okay, you're not the Terminator. I'm talking about the Terminator from the 90s with Arnold Schwarzenegger, you know, when he says, "Come with me if you want to live." You're not him. Okay, you're just not him. Instead, guys, the goal here is to improve your muscle memory so that your flicks become more natural and precise. It doesn't matter if you're missing a lot, all right? That's not even the focus. Just try to just concentrate on trying to hit the targets quickly. You don't want to just take your time with it, all right? You don't want to just stand still and just take your time. Speed is the name of the game when it comes to flicks, so you need to practice hitting them fast. All right, fine. I guess you can practice flicks standing still if you find them hard to land. But you almost never want to just be a still target in real fights. So eventually, you're going to need to get good at landing those quick shots while also moving your character. Practice by strafing left and right while spamming crouching, or by running towards an enemy like you would in a close range fight. It's harder than flicking while standing still since your target is moving a lot more on your screen. But where they move depends on how you move, so you just need to adjust your aim in accordance. With enough practice, I guarantee you guys, you're gonna start to notice yourself hitting flicks that you never even could imagine you can land. You're gonna start believing you're a superhero. Just don't run around in a costume or anything, okay? That'd be weird. Start off practice in Don Wozy's course with the stationary flick shot section. In here, you're gonna place your crosshair in the center and work on flicking to each target with a shotgun. Just remember to set your crosshair back to the center after each attempt. This is a great section for working on your muscle memory. The falling and bouncing zombies are completely bugged after a recent update, so until that gets fixed by Epic or the map creator, those two areas don't really have anything to check out, okay? The tile frenzy section is also a good place for you to practice while flicking between targets rapidly. You should just definitely include one or more of these courses in your routine. Really helps. If you're a controller player that needs help with flicking, well, there's a new setting that you can change to essentially turn off the acceleration when you move your joystick. So normally when you move your joystick in a direction, it starts off slowly and then builds up speed, right? But if you go to Accessibility tab under Settings, turn on Enable Foot Controller. Then set the foot controller dead zone and foot controller max throttle to their lowest. It'll turn off the acceleration. What this is going to do is make your crosshair movement consistent, and its speed will always remain the same no matter how long or short you hold the joystick. Mouse players turn off acceleration all the time, and in Fortnite, it's actually turned off by default. It makes aiming much more consistent, and you'll be able to build your muscle memory a lot easier. Some people might not like this setting, but you should give it a try if you're having trouble landing flicks. Unfortunately, though, it doesn't seem like it exists on Xbox for some reason. But you know what? There is a good chance it does get added in the future. But for now, Xbox players, you're out of luck. You know, it reminds me of the game Musical Chairs. You know, when you're going around in a circle and then the music stops and then whoever doesn't have a chair is out. That's what just happened to Xbox players. But like I said, you know, it's a good chance that they're going to be adding this in the future. So for now, it's okay. Don't get emotional. You'll get your chair back. Here we go. All right, so on next to tracking aim. This is the type of aim you guys want to use to laser players running in the distance or gliding in the air. Tracking, my friends, is all about reacting to your opponent's movement and adjusting your aim based on how they're moving. Like, if you see a player running in a straight line, you're going to react to that by putting your crosshair on them and then adjusting your crosshair based on their speed and direction. Then, if they change direction or jump, you react to that movement change and adjust your aim again. Part of good tracking, guys, is knowing how certain movements work in the game, like with gliding or running. But you also need to be in tune with your mouse or controller to execute it effectively. That's the biggest problem players have with tracking. They don't know how to translate what they're seeing on their screen into crosshair movement. That's why you need to practice. A good place on Dunwazi's map to warm up your tracking, start off with 360-degree close-range zombie tracking section. Then, if you want more of a challenge, hey, you can move on to the short strafe zombie tracking course. This one's a bit harder since the zombies constantly change speed, but it does make for some really good practice. As for projectile aim, like with sniper rifles, you actually end up using a lot of the same skills used with tracking. You're still reaching the player movement to line up a shot. The only difference is you're leading the bullet and adjusting for any drop. That's why it's so much easier to land snipes on players that run in straight lines. Or even when a player jumps, as you can just easily line up the shot to where they're landing. If you're an avid user of snipers, you definitely want to spend a bit of time training your shots against movement targets. The moving tile frenzy courses are really good for that. In there, you're going to get used to the projectile speed and bullet drop practicing. It's something you definitely want to practice if you find yourself missing a lot of shots against moving targets often. If you're able to start landing snipes on moving targets, I mean, you just open up so many more kill opportunities for yourself. Lastly, my friends, let's talk about Turtle Wars. If you haven't heard of it yet, Turtle Wars is a custom mode for creative that's basically a really intense deathmatch. You spawn in a big room, right? You choose some weapons and then go for a bunch of kills. Respawn is enabled, so if you die, don't worry about it. You'll just keep coming back again and again as much as you want. It's a really great way just to train your aim because it has constant engagements, close range fights, and it just throws building into the mix, which is amazing. So many fights and actual matches occur in close quarters, right? Especially in competitive end games, the place that we all want to master. So getting practice in that area has a lot of value. It's sort of like Team Rumble, but it's much more intense and a better simulation for competitive matches. Your aim assist isn't the only thing that's going to improve by playing Turtle Wars. With how many players are around you, the mode forces you to just learn how to properly defend yourself if you want to avoid repeatedly dying, which is super annoying. It also teaches you how to pressure players inside their boxes when they play defensively. Things like wall replacing, edits, and phasing into boxes are all techniques that are used here, so it's a great place to practice them. You can also learn how to effectively navigate through structures since you'll basically be surrounded by them. Having awareness of all the players around you and knowing how to approach them with builds is a skill all on its own. Turtle Wars really haven't changed much since Season 9 either. There hasn't really been any new features or additions since then for map makers just to go on and just update their work. So if you go search for Turtle War levels to play on and find some older posts, hey, do not be turned off by their age, okay? They might eventually get updated if new features or weapons get added, but until then, they're perfectly fine to play on. With how the creative code system works, you basically just need to follow the map creator on their YouTube or other social media to just be up to date on any changes. So if you want a good Turtle Wars map to play on, Saldrian's Turtle Wars is our favorite right now. It's a lot smaller than other maps, which makes the lobbies easier to fill and makes the games feel just way more concentrated. It can hold up to 12 players, but you can run fine with only a few players too. The first thing you're probably going to notice is how you can't build very high, but that's fine. Remember, guys, they're called Turtle Wars because the whole experience involves running throughout the build and looking for kills. It's not really a space to just try and build up high. If you need to find other players to play Turtle Wars with, hey, the best place to do that, ladies and gentlemen, is the Fortnite Pro League Discord server. In their creative chat room, you can post a message letting others know you're hosting Turtle Wars, right? Or you could just find somebody else and just join them. Since players like to practice their own rotations, it's mostly Zone Wars that gets played, but you can usually still make Turtle Wars lobby pretty easily. Check out the link in the description to join their Discord. So remember, guys, that the most important part of aim training is just getting in there and practicing. Muscle memory and intuition play a huge part in being a really good aimer, and that's just not something that just comes out of nowhere. It's something that takes time to develop, so you gotta get in there, you gotta practice. You guys just need to spend more time warming up as often as you can, and try as often as you can to get those Turtle Wars lobbies going, so they're not only gonna improve your aim, but they're gonna help a lot with other important skills that impact your game for the better. If you have any aiming tips, guys, yourself, you like to share, or maybe if we didn't go over something that you need to answer for, hey, let us know in the comments and we'll check it out. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is your guy, your friend, Keith Allen, and make sure to connect with me as soon as you can on my Instagram. I would love to hear from you.